Okay, Herman?
Yes.
Am I pronouncing it correct? Okay, you ended up bubbling out here twice as Milan.
Yes, I lost 50k round.
Right, against Joshua. You played Prankets, that's correct? Is there anything you want to say before you go to the list?
I think this was the best deck for this event.
Yeah.
But I think this deck is not very good if people know how to side against it.
Yeah.
Because the opponent sides Retaliating Sea, for example, you can't play.
Right.
So it really depends on like not being the best deck on the format, because you can never be the best deck on the format.
Okay.
Okay. So that's about
it. What's your list?
Yes. I'm playing 5 hand traps in the main deck. I thought it would be more striker than everything else, but I actually played just more Thunder Dragon than striker, so this wasn't very good. But impermanence is really bad in this deck, because you draw so many cards, and one of the draws is in the end phase, so you wanna be able to draw like hand traps. So,
it
was okay. Worst case, just banish it. Three fancies, this is Foolish Burial, and then special summon from the deck. This burns for 500, and special summons from the deck. This heals for 1000, especially from the deck. And this card is basically cycles your hand, you banish one card and draw one card and special summons from the deck.
That's the new one, right?
Yes, this came out this weekend.
This
deck is really good with the time procedures, because if you go into time, you can usually resolve this twice and this twice, one on your turn and one on your opponent's turn. And then you're ahead by 3000 life points and you special summon four monsters basically. So like no deck besides FTK can deal with that.
Yeah.
I play 3 of this field spell. It adds a prank kit card to the hand and buffs and debuffs your monsters. As a Thunder Dragon, you usually set this up, but without searching, just because of the attack boost. This is to not rip the terraformings, because this makes terraforming into polymerization.
Right.
But I don't know if I would play it again. Usually side this out.
Okay. Yeah.
3 of their in-themed polymerization. 3 of the infinite token generator, because you need to be able to get to 2 monsters to play. So if you open a full hand of prank kits, you can't play the game. Triple call by the grave, because usually you don't lose to any hand traps, but sometimes you just lose to every hand trap. So this is just like a safe point or safeguard. I don't know how to say it, but then 3 of this. This is like the best one, because it is the same as the other ones, it gets another monster onto the field. But also, if you draw it after turn 1, you summon basically like 1 Link 2 and 1 Prank It from the grave.
Yeah, it's basically
so one card Boreal Sword, basically, more or less.
Indeed.
And 3 normal polymerization, this is your best opening card, 1 upstart and 1 trap.
Right.
This card, you'll play 1 on this card, because that's Altergeist, you search this for the polymerization, and you can feather duster them in their end phase, and they can't do anything. And also the Sky Striker, it's like a free recycle, so it's really good, but not good enough to play 2.
Okay.
Side deck, played 3 Denko Sekka. I Denko killed a bunch of people, and some people didn't want to shake my hand, but you open this and poly and 2 prank it, and it's like 11,000, I think.
Right.
So it was really good. You set this in with a striker going first and second, because usually striker you need to grind, but if you open this, you just set up your normal play, and then in your turn you draw some Denko and you kill them. This is like the best hand trap in the side deck. You throw it against Thunder Dragon, against Rongo and everything. And as long as you open playable and open this, you win the game.
Right.
Played this, I said this like once today, it was okay. This is like the same thing as Denko, but against the trap decks. Because polymerization and 2 prank kits, or the fusion spell plus 2 prank kits, or token rater plus a prank kit, it's all like 90. So. And then 3 more hand traps.
Right.
This is like the best ones as combo if you go first, because you set up Butler, and then they have to have Soul Charge, and this negates Soul Charge. Extra deck, Harpy Sever Duster. Quick play Link Monster, you can cycle your cards from the graveyard. The best one, it only works in your turn, the second effect to add back, but the first effect is that when it's Link Summon, you can add a prank it spell or trap card. And so usually you send one with fancies and add one with this, so you always end on the polymerization plus the recycle or token generator.
Right.
Fusion monsters, instant fusion target.
Yeah.
This is on your turn and this is on your opponent's turn. And this card is Armadas, which means that if you kill Rei with a pranked monster, they won't be
right.
Kill Shisuke or Kagari. Rei won't be able to use its effect. And this is a direct attacker, which means that versus Thunder Dragon, if you can't outer board, you can do like 3,000 damage with this and boosted by the dog. And Lamp is in the grave.
Okay.
And this is Raigeki. This right, is the better one of the boss monsters. You make it usually like every game except for Striker. But you don't, you never make it.
Okay.
And other cards, Toad for the polymerization opener. Phoenix to push for game. Unicorn to push for game and to remove Thunder Dragons. Borreload to steal Titan. And Boral Sword to OK.
Right. Okay.
And that's all.
Is it possible to show like some basic combos just to get how the deck functions or works?
Yes, I can try to do that.
Yeah, because there are so many options.
Yes, there is a lot of options.
Yeah, I know.
I'll do a basic one.
Yeah.
You open like two of any prank. Well, you need to open Polymerization and Dropsis and any other pranky. And one card in hand for Roxas. So you play Polymerization and you fuse these together.
Yeah.
You summon this. And then you use both of these two in the graveyard.
Yeah.
To special summon more pranked monsters. And then you can tribute Rocket to special summon two more Prankits.
Yeah.
Usually end with this here, but it doesn't actually matter.
Uh-huh.
And then you make these two. Into the bird.
Yeah.
Then you use these two. Usually put this as Shining 1 and Shining 2 and Shining 3, but it doesn't matter as said.
Okay.
Which means that you will add this to the hand. Send this to the grave, and you will summon another Dropsis.
Right.
And usually Fancies. And then you make these two into Toad. And then you tag this out.
Yeah.
Which lets you add a prank kid and a spell. So you have these three in hand. And then you make these two into Bow Wow. When this card is tagged out in the opponent's turn, then your pranked monsters cannot be destroyed by card effects for the rest of the turn, not only the ones currently on the field. Which means that Thunder Dragon has no way to clear something that's under the protection of this and under the protection of this. So you will always end on two guys versus Thunder Dragon in the end phase. And just two guys is enough to do 8 key damage.
Right.
So this deck has a really good matchup against like the entire format besides FTK decks.
So your worst matchup is like the FTK danger variants.
Yeah, it's just no way you win unless you pack it.
Yeah. Okay. Any last words?
Not really.
Nice and quick. Thanks for the list. Congrats.